advantages of the new GL overview. The subsequent unit will elaborate on these benefits. You can also obtain the overview of advantages in SAP note number this. So there are advantages written in note. We will go through the SAP note as well. But before that, let's move into the advantages. The standard training course provides the GL overview of new GL and outline the possible functions within context of ERP financial. It may not yet be possible to use some of these functions such as document splitting in one or the other of the industry solutions. So that there are some limitations, we will come back and see what those limitations are. In version 9, April 2009, you can use SAP Service Place homepage to access IBU information. So it is IBU information is the individual business information is given there. Now we know the benefits of new GL. Okay. So just a quick recap. What are the benefits? It is summarized. And this diagram suggests a lot about the benefits of new GL. All these are the benefits or functionalities being added in new GL. So we should now be able to understand what are the benefits of new GL and what companies get after implementing new GL. Okay. Let's talk about Unit 2. So in the situation is initially with an SAP customer who had updated an R3 system with an ECC 6.0 and would now like to familiarize themselves with new GL, with GL accounting in a test landscape. As a result, new GL is not active. So after this unit, what we will be able to learn is activate the new GL, describe the importance of scenarios, this difference between entry view and the GL view, and define and derive segments. An understanding of the logic of the business functions and how to activate them. We will learn how to activate business functions. So we will learn the activation of new GL, familiarizing with the new totals table, FAGL flexed, assigning scenarios and their importance. There are multiple scenarios, 8 scenarios in new GL. We will talk about those. Entry view and the GL view, the characteristic segment, and then activation of business functions. Let's take an example. You know, before you can familiarize yourself with the working of new GL, you must be aware of a few basic facts, must make a number of important decisions, and must enter few settings in the configuration of SAP system. So we will see those configurations. Okay. So new GL first is a decision. Do I you my important question is, do I use to have new GL mandatory? The answer is, this is optional for existing customers. You will not be forced to activate the new GL. But for new installations, new GL will be active in the standard system. So for existing customers, it was an option. You continue using your classic GL. And for new customers, though new licenses by SAP, those it was mandatory to have new GL, because that's how the licensing works. SAP cannot sell the non-upgraded product. For existing customers, if you think the advantage described in the course 210 we are discussing, you can convert the new GL accounting into migration project immediately after the upgrade to SAP ERP. So before you come to new GL, you have to upgrade your system to SAP ERP ECC6, and then you can upgrade your migrate your system from classic GL to new GL. And what it will result in, it will result in the migration of the data from old tables to the new tables, and old tables get deactivated. Information for the new customers. In case of new installation, see note number this for information about setting up the new GL accounting. So it is when it's a free fresh implementation, this note describe about the basics of how to set up, that we will see in the configuration notes. So let me show you how to activate new GL first. SPRO. Configuration, financial accounting new, financial accounting global setting. And in the global setting, we have activate new GL accounting. There is a transaction code also, FAGL underscore activation. We can try directly that. But let's see how the node works. This is the one, activate new GL accounting. In this activity, you active new GL accounting. By activating the new GL, you achieve the following. The function for new GL becomes available. In SAP reference IMG, the previous financial accounting menu is replaced by financial accounting new under financial accounting global setting new. You activate the tables for new GL so that your posting data is written to them. So the moment you activate, you can your data will be written to the new tables, Fagel Flexed and Fagel Flexa, instead of Fagel Flex for instead of GLT0. So here new GL account is active. So it looks like, you know, this button, and then you save it. It says already saved. So from here, in normal situation, it looks like this without tick. Then you have to tick it and save it. Okay, it is not allowed to deactivate. Okay, so that's and that if you see the T code, it take me to the same screen. FAGL underscore activation. It takes me to the same screen. Okay. Moving on. This is performed at the start of course to enable you to explore new functions and practice executing this transaction in production is one of the last activities performed during migration project leading up to the implementation of new GL. So when we actually do the migration, this is the last step. For practice, we can do it early. But normally it is the last step. The reverse conclusion also means that new GL accounting is never activated automatically as a part of technical upgrade to ERP. When you do your upgrade from R3 to ERP, it does not mean that new GL will be by default active. New GL is not active. You have to activate new GL. That's how we did, you know, we just saw. It would be normal situation is that screen would be unticked, then you have to tick it, then you have to save it, and then it activates new GL. Also, you set the activation switch for each client, it cannot be activated on the company code level. So this is a client level setup. You cannot say that, okay, no, I will use new GL for 5 company codes and for rest 5 company codes, I'm going to use classic GL. It is not possible. Individual company level setting differ, but it is not possible to activate it by company code because if you see the screen, there is no option of company code. It is a client level setting and it has to be at the system level. However, activation results in system-wide changes to appearance of the application in customizing path. So the moment you activate, your new menu gets activated. So let me show you the menus. SPRO. And the moment we get into system, we will realize that if you see here, we have financial accounting, the old one and the new one. The moment you activate that, this menu automatically gets added. Financial accounting new. New means new GL is active. Okay. So these are the menu paths after activation. We just showed you the fun. Accounting global settings, new get activated and financial accounting new, the entire menu is changed. So this is this path for new GL are available in addition to the classic MIFI path. So then now you will see two configuration menus. Let me show you. Financial accounting and financial accounting new. So these two are visible now. So this is the new one which come here after activation of new GL, and this was the existing menu which was already there before activation. Okay. So we can even hide the classic financial paths, okay? So once you have become familiar with the path for new GL accounting, you can run the program this across the system to hide classic financial accounting paths. Let us check. Thank you. So it gives you option deactivate old IMG or activate old IMG. So if I do this, if I check now, you see the old menu is hidden now, it's not active. So we can do this, you know, it is if it is required. Normally it is does not make any impact of being hidden or available because all the configurations are done under new. But for the sake of just having the right optimized menu, you can hide that. Activating the new GL also makes several new nodes available in the application. If at the same point you want to see the work with the new path, the obsolete paths can be hidden with the program. This you can hide the old programs. Activating new GL accounting only affect the menu entry. The small number of classic functions and transactions cannot be executed anymore either. So it's not only the menu has changed, there are some additional things which will change. There are some existing transactions like for foreign currency valuation. So foreign currency valuation, the transaction code in classic is F.05. But in new GL, it is FAGL underscore valuation. So in place of F.05, you have to use the new transaction code. So the some transaction codes are also getting obsolete. It's not only the menu or configuration path. A lot of transactions are getting obsolete and all the existing old tables are getting obsolete. Okay. SAP will provide leading ledger 0L and the totals table with the standard system. So in SAP, the standard SAP provide the totals table, FEGL flexed, and 0L is the leading ledger. So this leading ledger is across the system, across company code. It has to be the standard. It cannot be changed. You cannot use leading ledger any different. It has to be across the company codes. The leading ledger gets many of its control parameter from the company code. The aim was to have major recognition effect. Specifically, the leading ledger manages the additional currencies. Leading ledger uses the fiscal year variant and it uses the posting period variant. So leading ledger will take most of this characteristic from the company code itself, not from the ledger itself, rather from the company code. So company code is the main supplier of all the features to the leading ledger.